Welcome back. On top of the parking garage on Linden Street in Allentown, as we prepare for the big bang, the conditions this morning are real good for it. The mayor has told us that the cloud situation is not a problem at all. So as far as we know, within about 23 minutes or so, we'll be ready to go. We're here with many, many reporters, some from other parts of the country. This will be seen in various parts of the country later today, evidently. And as you know, you can expect this is drawing a lot of attention, not just here in Allentown. The Corporate Plaza building, which is going to be imploded in a little while, has been a building that's had troubles for some time. It's only been around for about 9 years. During the course of the 9 years, there have been some difficulties with it, financial problems and other kinds. And now, of course, the big problem they're having right now. Channel 69's Janet Vassell gives us a look at some of the troubled history this building has seen.
When construction began on Corporate Plaza in the mid-1980s, the building was hailed as the start of a rebirth for downtown Allentown. The seven-story steel and concrete structure with a parking garage would provide modern office space to attract more white-collar jobs to Center City. It was built on the site of an old park and shop parking lot. The building was slow to fulfill its promise. Full occupancy was hard to achieve. And in 1988, the original owners sold Corporate Plaza to its current owner, Mark Mendelson. He too had trouble attracting enough tenants. At times, he fell behind in city taxes and in fees to the Downtown Improvement District. Only recently did the 8-year-old building find tenants for all its office space. What no one knew was that deep below the Earth's surface, something lurked that would mean the end of Corporate Plaza and would punch a huge hole in the heart of the city's downtown. February 23rd, the Lehigh Valley was digging out from yet another winter snowstorm. But Allentown would have bigger headaches.
We're standing on 7th Street in Allentown. And if you look over my shoulder, you can see the Corporate Plaza building. That's the newer building that you're looking at right now. Take a look at the problems with this building. There are major structural problems.
Emergency crews quickly learned that a giant sinkhole had opened up under the Corporate Plaza building and was stretching across 7th Street. The building was shifting and listing toward the sinkhole, and bricks and glass were flying into the street below.
Well, unfortunately, we just have to be a little patient and wait this thing out until somebody tells me that the building is, in fact, stabilized and it has stopped moving. We're not going to send any crews in to take a look at the sinkhole. The area has been abandoned for now. People are being put up in shelters. The businesses in this area have been asked to close down for today.
Channel 69 News was on the scene from the start. We were there as emergency crews and city officials watched the building crumble before their eyes. The structural damage was so severe there was no stopping it. Spectators gathered. Everyone was waiting and watching, even wagering just when the 7-story building would come crashing to the ground. By day's end, the city had issued owner Mark Mendelson a raise or repair order.
Tomorrow morning, it's my understanding the building owner will be coming back with some contractors and demolition should start sometime tomorrow.
Corporate Plaza owner Mark Mendelson hired Central Salvage Company to tear down the sinking building. The building's tenants were able to use the salvage crew to get into the twisted building and remove some of their belongings. Some roads were reopened and some residents were allowed to return. City crews filled the sinkhole in the street with concrete to stabilize it and prepare for the demolition work ahead. But that actually unwittingly made the job harder. The wrecking ball had little effect on the steel building. Officials realized the demolition crew would have to use dynamite to bring Corporate Plaza down. 15 days after the original collapse, a dramatic new development. A partial collapse that sent crews working inside running.
It just settled down one level at a time, just like stacking pancakes.
There was no question now. Corporate Plaza had to come down sooner, not later. Plans were escalated to demolish the building with dynamite. The collapse of Corporate Plaza is, of course, a big loss. A loss to the owner of the building, to the tenants, and the city itself. But Mayor Height is convinced that this loss will open new doors of opportunity for Center City.
We could look at the good side. Maybe they'll have two new office buildings, twin towers going up there. And that's where we're going to approach it.
We'll be watching, Mayor. Janet Vassell, Channel 69 News.
And we're back here on top of the parking garage. Corporate Plaza is behind us. Even now, the fire chief of Allentown is explaining how this is going to work with a five-minute siren from fire department trucks. I'm listening to him right now, in fact. And then we'll have another warning shot after that and a countdown to follow right down to the blast. And as far as we know, still scheduled for right about 9 o'clock. Explosives in place, blasters are ready, and we'll have it for you. We're going to take a brief break. We'll be back with our coverage of the implosion of Corporate Plaza.
Get ready for summertime fun with a pool or spa from Olympic Pools. Olympic Pools is setting new standards with their complete line of lifestyle pools, which come with a lifetime guarantee. Or why not unwind anytime with a vacation in your own home spa, which offers hydrotherapeutic design for years of enjoyment. Let your imagination run wild with a custom in-ground pool from Cardinal. With a pool or spa for every budget, Olympic also offers a full line of chemicals and accessories. So get into the fun today!
The difference between other IRAs and a self-directed IRA simplifier from Lehigh Securities is that there are no startup, maintenance, management, or closing fees. And Lehigh Securities makes it easier than ever. As a self-clearing firm, we work directly with you every step of the way, handling the entire service from low-cost order execution to no-cost custodianship. Call Lehigh Securities today. We're proud of the difference we make to our investors.
Yuck. Cleaning out gutters. Messy and dangerous. So get down from that ladder and get Gutter Helmet. You will never clean your gutters again. Guaranteed. Keep gutters free-flowing year-round. Eliminates freeze-ups and leaky joints. Keeps leaves and debris out of your gutter. And protects your roof shingles. Gutter Helmet. Affordable. Guaranteed. Call before the fall.
See Gutter Helmet at Agricultural Hall, Allentown, March 18th through the 20th.
When they told him he didn't have the size to play, he reached inside and found the power.
Starter.
He was from a small school in a small town, but he had the heart to make it big.
Starter.
Each had a dream, and when you start with a dream, where you end up is up to you.
Starter.
Starter and more, available at Sports Fever.
Back here on the parking garage on Linden Street. Corporate Plaza is behind us. As good a day as any, I suppose, for a building implosion. And we're going to have that at about 9 o'clock this morning. As far as we know, everything is all go for that. The conditions are right, and the button will be pushed over at Center Square. Now, over at Center Square right now, Newland Archinall standing by live. Newland?
Okay, Rob. Well, as you can see, there are a lot of workers just getting ready for some last-minute details, and the countdown is on. Joining me now is Allentown's Public Works Director, Neil Kern. And Neil, how's everything going? Everything on schedule?
Everything's on schedule. We just talked to demolition people. All the dynamite's set, all the wires are in place, and the button's ready to be pushed at 9 a.m.
Okay, now I understand the city has taken a lot of precautions to make sure that the area is buttoned down.
That's correct. There are police everywhere. There's only so many people who are allowed into this area. The mayor issued passes, and you had to have one of those to get in. We've had a lot of publicity over the past 2 days. Some buildings in close proximity have been evacuated. Most of the others people have been told to stay indoors, and the police are patrolling the areas to make sure people stay a safe distance away.
Okay, what about expecting any water or gas problems?
No, we have our standby crews on. UGI has crews here. Allentown Water Department is here just in case we're going to go around and sound the water mains in the vicinity right after the blast and some things like that. Just kind of extra precautions, trying to be safe rather than sorry.
Okay, so you're not thinking that there will be any more water main pipes as a result of some of this rumbling?
No, we really don't think that's the case, but we feel it's better to be safe, have a standby crew here and test the mains just to be extra safe because of the potential sinkholes in the area.
Okay, and they'll be checking right after the implosion?
Yes, our crews are stationed down behind the Reed Hotel, and within, 15, 20 minutes after the dust has settled and they can get out, they're going to go out and check all the water mains within a two-block radius of this area.
Okay, thanks so much, Neil Kern. Good luck.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Okay, well, People have been standing by, a lot of people with cameras and video cameras, trying to record this memorable moment. We've also told you in previous stories in our coverage that a lot of pieces of the building have been up for sale. The Downtown Improvement District Authority has been selling T-shirts and pieces of the brick to record the moment. So the commercialization of this entire project is taking on a life of its own. Ann Thomas reports.
Every cloud has a silver lining, or so the saying goes. So when a sinkhole swallowed the seven-story corporate plaza, Allentown officials tried to look on the bright side. They capitalized on public interest and raised money for local causes. They sold bricks, sweatshirts, and raffle tickets.
You ready?
Turn them around.
Okay, here, we gotta shake them up.
Shake those right.
Yeah, there we go.
The campaign, called the Big Bang, made big bucks.
We anticipating bringing in the neighborhood of $20,000, which would be split half and half with the Downtown Improvement District Authority and the Lehigh Valley chapter of the American Red Cross.
DITA will use the money to plant trees, and the Red Cross will replenish its emergency funds that were drained by a late January gas explosion and then the corporate collapse. Bricks, sweatshirts, and other plaza paraphernalia have been selling like hotcakes. It seems most everyone wants a piece of the plaza. But there are those who feel making money from the corporate collapse is not in good taste.
With all the tragedy going on, I mean, this upset a lot of people's lives, and they made a raffle out of it. But when I heard that they were giving the money to the Red Cross, and I felt better about it. I just hope that's what they do.
I'm not aware of that, but if they're doing that, I don't think it's really appropriate. I don't think it's appropriate to make money that way.
But Allentown officials say they're just taking life's lemons and making lemonade. And they add the true victims of the collapse support their efforts.
Mark Mendelson, the property owner who owns Corporate Plaza, has been extremely supportive of it. He was the one who suggested we do the sweatshirts. Some of the evacuees bought sweatshirts and raffle tickets, and Buyer Barber, who was a tenant in Corporate Plaza, bought $100 worth of tickets. So it's been well received.
In Allentown, Ann Thomas, Channel 69 News.
Well, the money that the city will make off all those efforts will certainly help offset some of the costs that the city has incurred this winter. There have been a lot of problems, not only snow-related and weather-related, but also with the corporate plaza. Now, everything appears to be on schedule on time, and that should help. They want to get this done as soon as possible. So some of the businesses here along Hamilton Mall can reopen for business. They're hoping to do a booming business today with some sales, with all the spectators that have come to watch this implosion. So that's the scene here from 7th and Hamilton. Rob, how do things look up your way?
Well, it's incredible up here, a booming business. I knew you were going to say something to that effect, Neil. And up here, there are lots of reporters, and across the way, you should hear the hooping and hollering on the Hess's parking garage a couple of blocks to our west. They have people lining the decks over there, and I wouldn't be surprised if they have a wave going. It's really something. A lot of noise around here as people watch. We're going to take a brief break in our coverage of the implosion. We'll be back in a minute.
A simple comparison between the Ford Escort LX and the competition. Ford Escort has fewer reported problems than both Honda and Nissan. Escort has more repeat buyers than Mazda, Toyota, and every other car in its class. And Escort outsells Saturn, Geo, and every other car in its class. So when you compare Escort to the competition, you might say it's simply in a class of its own. And for $199 per month for 24 months, it's simply a better deal at your Quality Plus Ford dealer.
Now that's a beautiful cup.
Hurry to McDonald's for your favorite extra value meal. And for 39 cents more, supersize it. You'll get more fries, more drink, and one of six MVP collector cups free, including Charles Barkley's, plus five other players.
What other players?
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Now at McDonald's, get a nothing but net hat celebrating Michael Jordan and Larry Bird's famous one-on-one game. It's yours for only $4.99.
What would you do with a Motorola pager?
Never miss a meeting.
Mom's not home. Pager.
All right, you got the pager number right.
We're going out.
Cool, this works.
A Motorola pager lets you stay in touch with the important people in your life while doing the things important to you. The affordable, portable Motorola pager.
Life goes on.
Motorola pagers are available at Lehigh Valley Page.
Yes, as a matter of fact, it was the middle of the night.
I was, I just called them and they came right away, and within a half an hour, dropped me off at home, and I didn't have to worry about the car whatsoever. It was all taken care of.
Supreme had me in a rental car within an hour. The paperwork, the estimate, and the car. I was on my way, and as a matter of fact, I was in time for my next appointment.
Oi, whoopee, I said. Boy, I couldn't be without a car.
Supreme Auto Body, celebrating 60 years of excellence.
And there we see some folks over on the parking garage at Hess's, where people are there in droves to watch the implosion, which is now just a few minutes away. The dynamite was put in place on Thursday. We want to show you some tape of what happened when they installed the dynamite and got the charges all ready to go. Let's take a look at that. The pictures come courtesy of Central Salvage Company and American Demolition. They hired Apple Productions of Bethlehem to go into the leaning, crumbling building, and the video was made available to Channel 69 News. These pictures you'll see come from the first floor and the basement of the building, and they were taken on Thursday. The demolition workers have their explosive charges and wiring ready to go. Implosion expert Jim Redike of Oklahoma is leader of this crew. He's brought down buildings around the U.S. and in other countries. This one's a special challenge since it's over a gaping sinkhole, but Central Salvage Company says Redike, whom they call the shooter, knows exactly what he's doing. As you know, it's not an explosion, but an implosion we're talking about here. The idea is to bring the whole building down in on itself. Now, explosions will be used in there in a very carefully controlled way. They will sever the supports inside the center of the building and then allow gravity to go to work. Gravity will start pulling the whole thing straight down. Workers attach the explosive charges to vertical beams. The charges will slice through the beams at just the right time and angle, allowing gravity to start pulling the building straight down. The imploders won't reveal all the beams they're targeting or the exact timing of the explosions because those are trade secrets. When the button is pushed at Center Square, the timed blasts will begin, wiping out the supports and dropping the building in a cloud of dust and leaving a stack of debris about two stories high. Now, we've been told the building is every bit as precarious as it looks, but apparently it's stable enough for workers on Thursday to do this. The workers didn't even appear to be holding their breath. They just calmly made their attachments and wired their wires. The building's special challenges for the Daikon blasters include the small distance between the plaza and the buildings next door to it, the crushed northwest corner that collapsed further after the original cave-in, and of course because of the big sinkhole underneath. That underground cavern will catch some of the debris that comes crashing down, but whether the sinkhole will shift or worsen, no one knows for sure. We'll certainly see a huge pile of junk left on the site after the dust clears, and workers will be clearing the junk away for quite a long time. On Thursday, when the pictures inside the building were shot, outside it was a beautiful day. Some fire crews were on the scene and a cherry picker looking the building over. The sun was providing some flashes in the broken windows on the building as if to give us a preview of the destructive flashes we expect to see when the button is pushed on Center Square. And speaking of Center Square, Newland Archinol is at Center Square right now with the gentleman who'll push that button. Newland?
That's right. Joining me now is Steve Pukshin, and you won the right to push the button. How did you find out?
Well, my wife called me. I was working at the Hess's South Wine and Spirits Shop, and she said, Steve, the mayor just called. I said, I think you wanted to join. And she gave me the phone number, and I called Mayor Height back, and he said, sure enough, are you ready to blow up a building or blow the building? I said, sure, why not?
And are you...
Go ahead.
Are you a little nervous?
No, not really.
That the fate of this building rests in your hands, that doesn't bother you?
Well, no, because it's those guys that put the dynamite charges that rest in their hands, so I'm just going to press the old button.
Did you ever imagine something? You'd do something like this?
Never in my lifetime, no, but I had a feeling I was going to win the drawing. I don't know why, I just did, so here
okay,
I am.
Well, good luck today. Thanks for joining us, Steve. Sure. So that's about it. I'm looking at the clock here. It looks like we've got about 4 minutes until the big moment. So we should start to hear some sirens pretty soon. The fire chief was out, and he's going to set off those sirens, the three-minute siren, then the waiting period, then the countdown. So we're all anxiously awaiting and trying to keep warm down here on the ground at 7th and Hamilton. A lot of workers have lined up. They're going to actually be talking, or rather shielding themselves from a wall right behind them. They'll all step behind that behind the monument here at 7th and Hamilton, about three dozen workers right now, all wearing hard hats. That's to keep themselves protected from any sort of falling debris when the corporate collapse, or corporate plaza, caves in and implodes. So that's the scene right now here from 7th and Hamilton as we wait anxiously for the big bang. Rob, you've got the best seat in the house. Here on the ground, we're not going to be able to see much. How do things look there?
Well, kind of anxious about the fact that I've got the best seat in the house because this thing is right in our face. It really does seem close. It's a half a block away, and we're going to have a great view. In fact, the fire chief, who's been up here also on top of the parking deck, has told us to be ready to duck down. There may be some flying rivets or debris of some kind coming in our direction pretty quick after those charges go off in there. So we're ready and waiting, and I'm prepared to duck down behind a wall that's about 3 feet tall here. Actually, all of us, all the dozen or more TV cameras along this wall are standing on an ice pack, so it doesn't make our footing any better. If we're going to feel some shockwave coming over the wall, we're going to be standing on ice as we receive that shockwave. So as you see, all the reporters there, there are national media here, people from markets closer to the Allentown area. There are at least three helicopters now hovering over the area. They are just a bit to the north and east of the building, keeping a pretty good distance, as you might imagine, because when the blast does go, there will be a concussive effect straight up and off to the sides. The straight up is what they were concerned about. Had there been a low cloud ceiling, they wouldn't have been able to do it because the straight up shock wave would have bounced off the cloud ceiling and come right back down. I think the time where we were showing you a clock a few minutes ago is going to be quite approximate because the fire chief who'd been up here a few minutes ago said, contrary to what we heard earlier, as far as I understand it, that we would hear fire trucks giving some blasts at 5 minutes before we have the implosion. And now we are coming up on 8:59 by my watch, and we have not heard any of those sirens yet. So we'll be waiting and seeing and taking it easy here and waiting for the word from the siren, the sound from the sirens to come up here. Once the sirens go, there'll be a few more minutes, and then there will be on the PA system a countdown that we can hear. And of course, we'll be able to show you that Steve Pookson will be able to hit that toggle switch. Let's take a look now at the toggle switch, in fact, that we are talking about. This is our camera from Center Square. We're looking at the toggle switch device that Steve Pookson's going to be throwing in just a few minutes. They're getting it all ready. They're behind the monument, these soldiers and sailors' monument on Center Square. And they are ready, Mayor Height told me, to duck down behind the monument base when the switch is hit, because they're not quite sure, of course, how much of the effect they will feel there at the monument, which is, again, about a half block down from Corporate Plaza. So that's the device all ready to go, as far as we know. And Steve Pookson, who said he felt like he was going to win the drawing. He didn't know why, but he felt like he was going to win. And in fact, he did win the drawing, and he was notified, and there we go. You can hear a siren being set off now. 3 minutes, okay. I just got the word Chief Novosat is right here. He says that means 3 minutes to go. 3 minutes to the implosion at Corporate Plaza. These sirens are going to run a little bit now, but we have started apparently our 3 minute countdown, approximately. We'll see the Corporate Plaza building get ready to go there. We are expecting that we will feel quite an effect up here. And of course, the whole area has been cordoned off. There are people on the Hess's parking garage a couple of blocks west. And we're not sure quite what they are going to be feeling up there, but certainly the city has deemed it safe enough for them to be watching from that standpoint. And of course, there are people who are in the six block area, or rather on the periphery of the six block area, watching from street level as well. The best view, of course, is going to be right here from the top of our location here on the parking garage. We also will be showing you other views as well on our camera angles that we have from the PP&L building, and of course our after the implosion we'll be able to show you the destructo cam view, we hope, the camera that's down on 7th Street. We're going to take a quick break now just for a few seconds, and then we'll come right back. See you in a minute.
If you think you have to spend over $20,000 for a four-door, four-wheel drive sport utility, think again. Lehigh Valley Suzuki offers a 1994 four-door, four-wheel drive sidekick for only $13,995. That's only $13,995, or you can lease it for only $199 a month for 36 months. Lehigh Valley Suzuki, a Vinard dealership on the Lehigh Street Auto Mile.
hear a siren, we are told 1 minute to go to the implosion of Corporate Plaza. Chief Novosat has told us this is 1 minute. After the siren is sounded here, we'll get down to the last few seconds, and there should be a countdown that we can hear. Hopefully you'll be able to hear the countdown over the air. Not quite sure about that yet. We're now less than a minute to the implosion of Corporate Plaza. Everything is ready. Steve Pookshin of Allentown is ready at the toggle switch on Center Square. He'll be hitting that switch at the end of the countdown, and that will set off the explosive charges that are attached to vertical steel columns inside the building. They'll be going off in a carefully timed pattern and bringing those columns, severing some of those columns, bringing them folding down into the interior of the building. 10. Countdown now. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There it goes. They said it would take just a few seconds. And now it's gone. And now the dust cloud is approaching the parking deck where we are here on Linden Street. The implosion has taken place. And now you're taking a look from way up high on the PPNL camera as a big cloud spreads through Center City, Allentown. And cheers can be heard from people around the area who are down on the streets and over on the Hess's building. We've seen this thing go. Now the dust is approaching us here on top of the parking garage on Linden Street. And of course, from my vantage point now, on this parking garage top deck, cannot tell you at all what it looks like over at the implosion scene because the cloud of dust is so very thick. It is spreading to the east in our direction. And we cannot see a thing at this point now. In fact, I'm not even sure what you are looking at on the air. Maybe somebody can tell me. There we go, back to the high up camera where there's some visibility from PPNL. A little bit of dust in my eye here. And of course, a lot of people on the top of this parking garage are experiencing the same thing now. We have not seen anything up here in terms of debris of any significant size. We just see particles of dust floating over. And the Corporate Plaza building, I'm trying to peek through now the dust. You can't still see through the cloud on the level we are at this point. You can see from the high up camera a big cloud of dust sitting over the site on 7th Street. Now, with the Destructo cam is on now, we're going to show you, this is a camera right down on the street level. We'll take a look at what it saw when the blast went off. The Destructo camera was not destroyed. Is that correct? Okay, we are looking at a live picture. I thought we were going to see the tape. The Destructo camera has survived the blast, and we're looking at a live picture from right down on 7th Street, right into the debris, the rubble from the Corporate Plaza building. Unbelievable. The building is gone. The dust is clearing out a bit here, and as I get back to about where I was, I can see the rubble, the steel twisted down. And of course, they told us it would be about 2 stories high, what was left. And in fact, that's about what you have there, a big pile of junk. Some of it only about 1 story high, it looks. It's come down into like a big stack of pancakes, although there are some steel girders that are twisted and jutting into the air on the north side of the building. And a big gray dust has settled over the snow that was on the ground all around here. Apparently things have gone well. Have not heard from official sources at this point as to whether there has been any damage to any of the adjacent buildings or any debris flying in any particular direction. Again, from our vantage point just to the northeast of the explosion, we have just a cloud of dust, which is now, in fact, clearing away at this point. The helicopters are circling overhead, taking their pictures of the remains of the building on Center Square. Newland Archinal, how did it go over there?
Well, let me tell you, those bangs were pretty loud. We were standing down here. I had to shield myself behind a wall right behind the monument, and there was just a big dust cloud that came rolling through, and it was very burning to the eyes because that dust contained a lot of debris, so you had to shield your eyes also. But as you can tell, I don't If you can see, you can just see that there's just a mass of brick rubble right behind me. A lot of the workers went flying over with their cameras. They wanted to see what was left, and it looked like it really took about 8 seconds from the beginning of the implosion to the end, to the where the dust rolled out. And as you can see, people just standing around it in belief. Looks like things went pretty well. I don't see any structural damage to any of the other buildings down here on 7th and Hamilton. So it looks like everything stayed pretty clear and things went according to plan. So all in all, pretty successful here from 7th and Hamilton. The dust cloud has rolled up. We're hearing helicopters down here too, who are probably flying over the site to see what is left. And things, though, pretty quiet. We don't see any spectators. They've still not been allowed to pass through. Right before the bang, we should mention that a group of people came walking through just about 5 seconds before they pushed the toggle switch, and that created a lot of disturbance here. A lot of police went rushing to clear them out of the area. Not sure how they got there, so that's the scene here from 7th and Hamilton. Rob, how do things look up your way?
Well, things are clearing out real nicely right now. The dust cloud has kind of blown on through, and as you can see behind me, you have the rubble. It's all crushed in the center of the building. It seems to have collapsed. Perhaps some of that stuff has fallen into the remains of the big sinkhole that is the cause of the problem here in the first place. We're going to be able to show you in just a few minutes a replay from various angles and speeds of what the implosion looked like. We're going to take a brief break. We'll come back, and we'll show you that.
For the Arby's Melt Sandwich, just 99 cents. Loaded with fresh sliced roast beef. The Arby's Melt comes with a thick, velvety blanket of tangy melted cheddar. Just 99 cents for a limited time. Ouch. The Arby's Melt, just 99 cents right now. Proving once again that America is a great country and different is good.
Enjoy a winter sports holiday at Pocono Manor Inn. Pocono Manor Inn offers affordable bed and breakfast ski packages that include overnight accommodations, a hearty mountain breakfast buffet, and a lift ticket to nearby major ski areas. Pocono Manor Inn also offers cross-country skiing, an ice skating rink, indoor swimming pool, and so much more. Pocono Manor Inn has all the beauty and charm of the Poconos, and you can be busy or just relax.
Allentown Jewelers announces their after-holiday stock reduction sale. Diamond engagement rings, precious and semi-precious stone jewelry, all carat gold jewelry at an unbelievable 60 to 70% off our lowest ticketed price. Why pay more when you have Allentown Jewelers? Allentown Jewelers has engagement rings starting at $79. Also, three-ring wedding engagement sets starting at $75. So remember, 60 to 70% off at Allentown Jewelers, Hamilton Mall, Allentown.
As colossal an undertaking as the building of the Verrazano Narrows Bridge, involving the most skilled of craftsmen, as awe-inspiring as the raising of the Empire State Building, promising a bright future for all carpet buyers, giant equipment has leveled the land, and the foundation is being laid for this modern miracle. The bigger and better Crest Wholesale Carpet Distributors coming soon. Join Crest as they reach towards the next century. Crest Wholesale Carpet Distributors, Route 222, West Coastville, where no sale will ever beat wholesale.
Welcome back to our live coverage of the implosion. The deed is done. Took about 8 seconds, a tremendous blast or series of blasts and a tremendous dust ball. It all came flowing in this direction. As you can see now, the building is knocked down totally. And we are going to show you some pictures of it that we have not been able to show you before. You have not seen the ones we're going to show you. We're going to go to our PP&L camera and give you a replay of what the blast looked like from that camera. That camera, of course, way up toward the top of the PP&L tower, a 23-story building just to the west of the now collapsed Corporate Plaza building. That camera and others, we had rolling tape and getting various angles of what it looked like. We'll see the up top. We saw some of the aftermath, of course, of the dust cloud from up high on PP&L. But what we have not yet been able to see is the blast itself from that camera. Now we have that ready. Let's take a look at the tape from high up on the PP&L building and see what the blast looked like from there. And there it goes. as planned, sinking in the middle, collapsing into itself, and success, as far as we can tell. Implosion as seen from high atop the PP&L building. And all went well. The blast was just tremendous. We did not, though, feel here, although you heard the sound and you could feel a little bit of the shock and the jolt of it. It was not any tremendous shock wave of the sort that might knock us off our feet. And the debris did not come flying into our face. Now, we're going to take a look at the picture from this angle on top of the Linden Street garage, and we'll take a look at it in slow motion. Let's take a look at what that looked like. And here it is, replay in slow motion. Now you can see the blasts inside going off, carefully timed, and there they're bringing down the interior building of the building. The columns are severed. It collapses in the center and starts coming down just as the imploders intended it to do. A massive pile of debris, and in just a few seconds it was done. They said it would be about 8 seconds for the whole thing to happen because the cloud of dust became so huge and came to us so quickly we couldn't be sure exactly when the end of it had taken place, but it was a tremendous sight and sound. And now there's a pile of debris, a huge pile there that will be there for some time. The demolition crews now have a tremendous job. Now we're going to take a look at what happened over at the toggle switch itself on Center Square, where Steve Pukchin was standing by to hit that switch.
Barry, we're not getting audio.
Are we looking now at right after it happened? And Carl Mason from Central Salvage celebrating. You high fives there, I think. That was the scene at Center Square. After the toggle switch was hit by Steve Pukchin, who said he thought he would win that raffle and win the ticket to push the button, and so he did. He hit it, and a big celebration broke out there with the demolition crew seeing that their job had worked as planned. Now we're going to show you the view from our Destructo cam. The Destructo cam survived, and we have pictures from the camera, and we'll take a look at that now, what it looked like from Destructo cam, which is right down on 7th Street. This is a real-time picture, not in slow motion. The camera right down across the street from the building as the blasts went off inside. Looking at the replay from our camera right down on the street. There we go. Wow. Unbelievable. And the camera survived the blast. It became enveloped in the cloud of dust and debris. Some of the debris sticking to the lens, apparently, but the camera made it through. Dramatic pictures of what it looked like when all those blasts went off. Of course, not one single blast, but a number of dynamite charges timed in such a way as to bring the building down in the center of the building. And then once those columns were severed, the whole thing just came down in a big pile and a tremendous dust ball. And now that's all pretty much cleared out on this beautiful Saturday morning. Now we're going to take a look at a slow motion picture of what it looked like. The Destructo camera slow motion picture. Let's go back to that tape now and see what this looked like in slow motion. We call it Destructo cam, and here it is, slow motion. You see charges going off inside. The debris is starting to fly out toward the camera and all around. The center columns of the building are severed. It starts to fall, and of course there is debris all over the place. Although, just as planned, it's contained to an area pretty closely around the building. And as opposed to an explosion, which throws things far and wide, an implosion keeps it right there in the building area. And that is what the plan was, in fact, to keep the debris to within about 150 feet around the edges of the building. We're going to take a brief break now in the aftermath of the implosion, talk to Newland Archinall over at Center Square. That's when we come back.
So, you're thinking about a new mid-size car? How about this new Oldsmobile Cutlass Supreme Special Edition? It comes with anti-lock brakes, V6, power locks, cruise, air, cassette, driver's airbag, and more, all for $17,195. The Honda Accord LX costs $2,000 more than the Supreme. Uh-huh. It's your money. Now at your local Olds retailer.
Now there's one more reason to call Jack Larry Electric. Besides being a family business with over 30 years' experience and installing only top-quality Trane heat pumps, Jack Larry has grown again and is now in a new, larger facility to serve you better with Trane heat pumps in stock. Ready to be installed in your home for affordable year-round comfort. 50 million people take comfort in Trane. Call Jack Larry Electric today at 797-LEHR. That's 797-LAIR. And remember,
that's Jack Larry Electric.
If you're like most of us, there's some days when you just want somebody to take care of you. You want to feel pampered, protected, and told everything's okay. You want to feel somebody's looking out for your interest. At Keystone Savings Bank, we'll give you the attention you deserve. Keystone's been helping people in the Lehigh Valley with their banking needs since 1925. And if there's one thing we're good at, it's making you feel at home. And that's a very comforting feeling. Keystone Savings Bank. It's nice to have somebody on your side.
Design. You can tell that the all-new Armstrong Evolution was designed to be a breed apart just by looking at it. Here, design engineers employ three deep grooves to maximize water drainage and minimize hydroplaning. The aggressive square block tread design results in outstanding traction in the wet and in the snow. The all-new Armstrong Evolution, made right here in America for American roads and American weather, and available at these Fred Midland discount tire centers.
We're taking a look at a shot from live atop the PP&L building, looking down at what was the corporate Plaza building, the big hole now in the center of it. The implosion went as planned just a few minutes after 9 o'clock, leaving a tremendous pile of junk, basically, there. In fact, Mayor Height is on top of the parking garage where we are now, and has just said jokingly to Steve Pukshin, who pushed the button, that you sure made a mess of our city. And they all had a good laugh over that. And of course, the implosion has leveled the building as planned. It was deemed the best way to bring the building down. The wrecking ball wouldn't do it. They've done it this morning, and it looks like it's very successful. Okay, we're going to move the camera just a bit here, and you can see the parking deck where we are now. As we zoom in, you see the crowd that's right here. You see me waving here on the edge of the deck. Just behind me this way is a news conference. The news conference is going on right over here with Mayor Height and with Steve Pukshin, who pushed the button. Apparently things have gone well. From our vantage point, unfortunately, we're not able to hear exactly what they're saying about whether there have been any difficulties or whether things went very smoothly. I believe Newland had told us a few minutes ago that as far as she could tell, there were no difficulties over there at the square. And I think we can go back to Newland now and see if you've learned anything more about how things went. Newland?
Well, Rob, here from the scene, as you can see, things are just a mass of twisted steel and bricks, and there's city officials standing around. And I talked to the mayor just a short time ago. He said everything went according to plan. Very excited. This is a tremendous moment and a tremendous victory for both the company and the city. Of course, this was a first for them. They were imploding a building over a sinkhole, which Central Salvage Company had never done before. A very unique situation, and it came off without a hitch. They are very pleased today. So things have gone extremely well. Right now, we're showing you a wide shot, as you can see, what the other buildings in the area look like. None of them were damaged in this. And when we saw the first implosion go off, there were just shards of glass and brick shooting out in all directions. I thought, honestly, that some of the buildings would be hurt by that, but apparently they are not. There seems to be no structural damage to anything down here on 7th and Hamilton. Also, we want to show you where the spark and the implosion actually happened. It happened right here. There was a set of wires that actually just got disconnected. They were linked down across the street, and they went all the way down 7th Street to the building. They were hooked up to seven stacks of copper explosives that were set off, and that brought the building down. Otherwise, things around here are pretty clear and pretty quiet. Nobody's been allowed back in this area. Police are still cordoning it off and not allowing spectators back in. There's a lot of insulation around the street, and there's still some dust that's blowing through here. We're going to show you what the street looks like right now. If you can take a look over down Hamilton Street, you can see that there's a lot of insulation that made its way down this far and just came sailing through. As we mentioned, still some dust in the air. The wind is carrying things across, some of the lighter stuff from the building, but things have settled down quite a bit, and it seems like it was a very successful implosion and a real victory for the city of Allentown. And that is the scene here at 7th and Hamilton. And Rob, we understand the mayor is talking to the press up in your area.
Well, Newland, not only the mayor, but a lot of other people who are involved. And this gentleman here is Jim Redike, who's with the blasting company Dicon out of Oklahoma. They call you the shooter, I understand, Jim. Huh? And things went well today? You were pleased?
Delighted, absolutely delighted. It couldn't have been any better. This is probably the most difficult building I've ever done. I've did a lot of buildings in Mexico City after the earthquake, but never one in this condition or state.
Was the sinkhole the big problem?
Well, the sinkhole, obviously, because we had a lot of failure in there. A lot of the columns had dropped 5 or 6 feet, and we lost the beam, the column integrity in the mass. And so that's the reason that we shot upstairs so much to get failure in it. And it did exactly as I expected. I want to thank the contractors and everybody in the city, and most of all the good Lord for his blessings.
Now, we saw the series of blasts, and I know it's kind of a secret as to how you exactly do that, but when you saw it happening, you could tell right away that things were going just as planned, huh?
Basically, I mean, you heard 4 or 5 different explosions, and that's the center. The center went off at the early sequence, and it, as it dropped down, the next line of columns went off so that it would be drawn in toward the middle, and that's exactly what you saw. The key points to watch were the tall columns and what happened to the columns, and it knuckled exactly like I talked about, and it just barely touched that little red building with a hole about a foot in diameter. So, and that's that kind of what we expected, but I was worried more about this north end because of the failure and the collapse, as you saw that the roof of that had already collapsed. So we were in a real difficult situation at that end. So I'm absolutely delighted that it went as it did.
Well, congratulations on a great blast. Good to talk to you. Okay, we have some others here on the roof we want to get a chance to talk to. I'm going to ask the director right now. Can we do this right now? Okay. All right. We're going to get over here and kind of horn in on an interview with Steve Pukchin. Actually, Mayor Hyde is over here. This is Steve, who is the shooter, or rather the one who hit the trigger. The shooter, of course, was, we just talked to Jim Redike. Steve?
Hi.
How'd it go?
Beautiful. Nice.
We saw some celebrating on our replays down at the square. Were you doing some of the celebrating down there, some high fives and so forth?
No, just everybody was just sort of saying beautiful, awesome, and stuff like that, and congratulating each other on their excellent job, which they did. They worked out perfectly for them. Supposedly only a couple windows got blown out, and they consider it a perfect job.
What did it feel like to you down there? You had this awesome responsibility, and in the last few seconds of the countdown, what was going through your mind during that countdown?
Oh, I was just waiting for the countdown. Nothing was really going through my mind. I just wanted to watch, just watching the building, and had my hand on a switch, and when they said fire, I threw the switch and just watched the building go down.
What a feeling of power, huh? Doesn't it give you a big head, Steve?
No, not really.
Not really?
No, not really.
Just a humble guy, Steve, huh?
Well, don't go that far.
Oh, you wouldn't go that far, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, now all you have to do is hit those lottery tickets tonight, and you'll be all set, huh?
I hope so.
Okay, other people want to talk to you, Steve. Congratulations on the big bang. Success here at Center Square in Allentown, the building of big bunch of rubble. Mayor Hyde joked a few minutes ago that Steve had made a mess of the city, and so he has, at least in that area. Now the dust is all blown away, and you can see the work that remains. Jim Redike's crew has blown it to bits, and now remains for Central Salvage to take all that stuff away over there, and that's going to be a long, long, long progress. We're going to take a brief break and give you another look at what happened this morning, the big bang in Allentown. We'll be right back.
Talk about excitement. You've got to be talking Toyota trucks, because you can't miss with the truck sale on now at your Toyota dealer. Toyota, the number one truck line in customer satisfaction, is offering big excitement with great deals on rugged 4x2s, tough Toyota 4x4s, and the big T100. For a limited time only, get low 4.4% financing, payments up to 48 months, plus extra value package savings and factory-to-dealer incentives. 4.4% financing, but time is limited. Get into Toyota trucks. Get into the excitement now.
It's time for Flyers Trivia.
Are you ready, Gene?
Yep.
Who is a dedicated sponsor of Flyers Charities year after year?
Easy. H&R Auto Radio in Warminster and Allentown.
Right. And Gene, how many years has H&R shown the same dedication to their customers?
30 years, my friend.
Right, Gene. H&R is celebrating 30 years of sales, service, and installation.
H&R has two beautiful sales, service, and installation centers in Warminster and Allentown. So, Bobby, for 30 years of sound ideas in your car,
it's H&R.
Enjoy a winter sports holiday at Pocono Manor Inn. Pocono Manor Inn offers affordable bed and breakfast ski packages that include overnight accommodations, a hearty mountain breakfast buffet, and a lift ticket to nearby major ski areas. Pocono Manor Inn also offers cross-country skiing, an ice skating rink, indoor swimming pool, and so much more. Pocono Manor Inn has all the beauty and charm of the Poconos, and you can be busy or just relax.
If you're like most of us, there's some days when you just want somebody to take care of you. You want to feel pampered, protected, and told everything's okay. You want to feel somebody's looking out for your interest. At Keystone Savings Bank, we'll give you the attention you deserve. Keystone's been helping people in the Lehigh Valley with their banking needs since 1925. And if there's one thing we're good at, it's making you feel at home. And that's a very comforting feeling. Keystone Savings Bank. It's nice to have somebody on your side.
Okay, we're back live on top of the parking garage on Linden Street with Mayor Bill Height and Carl Mason from Central Salvage. And what did you think down there? I saw a few high fives, I think, in our replay, Carl.
That was an absolute outstanding success. Everything went beautifully. We're thrilled with the outcome, and it was just a real great, terrific group effort in making this a successful engineering feat, is the way I refer to it, because that's what it was.
Well, congratulations on that.
Thank you very much.
As we talked to Steve Pukchin, the shooter, the button pusher, a few minutes ago, he said he wasn't agitated at all in the countdown, Mayor. I wonder what you felt, maybe a little different as the countdown ticked down?
Well, I was a little apprehensive because you don't know what the finished product is going to be, but now that I see it, I'm ecstatic that the building is down and we can start to put our utilities back and get the people back in their homes and back in their businesses and start working to rebuilding Allentown rather than tearing it down.
No difficulties that you're aware of now that the dust has blown away?
None that I can see. A couple windows, but I think Carl doesn't mind that at all.
No, really, that's just minor damage. And I want to personally thank the mayor. Our success was mostly attributable to the cooperation we got from him and all the people that work for the city. And we really do appreciate that. He did a great job.
Congratulations to you both. Thanks. We're going to take a look at some replays now of the blast and take a look at what it looked like from various angles. We had a high up angle at PP&L. And, of course, our Destructo cam, which was down on 7th Street right next to the building. And the camera survived somehow. Which one are we going to look at first? Oh, we're going to look at the button pusher first. Okay, let's take a look at that tape. Steve Pukchin over at Center Square. Congratulating, I'm sorry, I can't see any of the pictures, guys, so we'll just have to go with it as it is. The button pusher, Steve, hit the button as planned. Congratulations all around on the square, of course. And, as we just heard from the salvage people, they were ecstatic. The mayor is ecstatic. Things worked out just beautifully. Now we're taking a look at my vantage point here on top of the garage on Linden Street. There it goes. They said it would take just a few seconds. And now it's gone. And now the dust cloud is approaching the parking. Okay, taking a look then at the view from the PP&L building, the camera way up above and just to the west of the implosion. There it goes, a huge cloud of smoke rising above the building as the blast went off a few minutes after 9 o'clock, and in just a few seconds it was done, and the dust cloud began to blow away from the blast area. They're calling it a tremendous success, and we'll look at it now from our destructo cam, which survived. There it goes. Incredible pictures from right across the street on ground level. The blast went off as planned, hurling debris out of the building. The building came crumbling down. And according to the demolition people, it did so just as planned. According to Jim Redike, who's with the Dicon company, he said it was the most difficult blast he had done. And he's done hundreds of them over 20 years. He said it was more difficult than others he had done, including the ones he had done in Mexico following the big earthquake down in Mexico, which, of course, would present tremendous challenges. Here, the challenge, of course, was the big sinkhole. And apparently, they have conquered that challenge, and the building is now down. Newland Archinol was taking in everything from over on Center Square, where the button was pushed. Newland?
Okay, Rob. Well, right now, we're hearing a couple of panes of falling glass coming from a building. UGI officials are cruising through here. They're just checking it out to make sure that there are no gas leaks. I wonder if you can hear that as they fall down. It's pretty loud. Anyway, UGI officials and power crews have been cruising through here to make sure that everything checks out okay. There are no gas leaks, there are no water main problems, and there are no power problems. As soon as that is complete, city police tell me they plan to reopen the streets to traffic, and then it will be business as usual, despite one of the most historic events here in downtown Allentown. Simply tremendous. You can see the picture of what is left of Corporate Plaza right here at 7th and Hamilton. As you can see, just twisted steel and crumbling bricks, and people are getting their bricks. City workers have been running up, grabbing a piece of the action to take home with them as a memorabilia of this historic moment. So that is the scene here from 7th and Hamilton. Things went extremely well, and the city is just couldn't be more pleased at this point, considering that this was a really unique situation for them and this implosion. And right now, as you can see, just some city officials wrapping things up and making sure that everything is okay. And that is Police Chief John Stefanik, and they're going to send out the troops and try and reopen things up. Things seem to be back to normal in the city of Allentown. And that is the scene here from 7th and Hamilton and Hamilton Mall. Rob, back to you.
Okay, thanks very much, Newland. You're looking at the junk from our vantage point at the garage on Linden Street, the rubble left from Corporate Plaza, a tremendous blast that it was, and now workers are down there in the rubble, straightening things out, or perhaps, as you said, collecting a few mementos to save from this tremendous event this morning. It has happened. It's gone very, very well, according to city officials, according to the blasters who set off the dynamite. A tremendous challenge they faced has been conquered. They've accomplished what they set out to do. And now, as Mayor Hite said just a couple of minutes ago, it's time for Allentown to rebuild, to be thinking about the future and making the downtown a better place to be now that this hurdle has been conquered. It'll be a long time before all the junk is removed, but once that's finally done, they'll be able to rebuild here. It may be a parking lot first, and then who knows what else may rise from the ashes of the now imploded Corporate Plaza building. It's done, and that's our coverage this morning. Thank you for being with us on this beautiful Saturday morning, the day of the Big Bang. It has happened and gone well. We'll have complete coverage of today's events on Channel 69 News tonight at 7 o'clock. I'm Rob Vaughn for Newland and all the Channel 69 News team. Thanks for watching, and have a good day.